And during that festival, the famous masked dances take place. And we're going to now show you one of those masked dances. It's called Shama, the Stag and the Buffalo. And it's performed on the 29th day of the old year, and it's in part of preparation for the new year coming. The first part of the prayer is to purify that water until it is really clean and fit, in fact, for the gods. They then imagine that they are summoning the Buddhas here and that they're dissolving into a small mirror, which is like a circular piece of metal. So we have the Buddhas actually inside this mirror or melon. They then offer a ceremonial scarf. It's a silk scarf like the one here on the throne. And this is held above the mirror to represent the offering of a house to the Buddhas. Then water is poured onto the mirror, and this symbolizes the washing of the Buddha's body, speech, and mind. And while they're doing that, they're imagining the same thing, the same action happening to people, to sentient beings, so purifying the body, the speech, and the mind of each individual. Then the kata, or the scarf, is used to dry the body, and you see this action of drying on the mirror itself. And then the monks make an offering of very special clothes to the Buddha, and this is illustrated with this brocade cloth called a tengu. And then once this ceremony is finished, the mirror is raised again in the air and the Buddhas are requested to return to their own realm. He took a white horse and he covered it with charcoal and a black cloak with a white lining. And he rode to Lhasa to dance at the new year in front of the king. In the costume of the black hat dancer, he was able to hide a bow in one sleeve and an arrow in the other. And in the middle of the dance, he drew out his bow and shot an arrow through the king's heart and assassinated him.